guys, welcome to my channel. Today's video, I'm going to be giving you a look at Master Books Let's Talk Science Adventures on Planet Earth. This is their level 3 or 3rd grade level of science for the Let's Talk series. You've been around my channel, you know that I have been debating on which science curriculum to use for our upcoming homeschool year, and I said in that video, regardless of what I choose, I would be sharing looks and my thoughts on the specific curriculum. So today I will be sharing this one with you guys. All right, so this is from Master Books. You do need to know though that Master Books has a few different elementary science series. So this is part of the Let's Talk Science series. This one is specific to Planet Earth. All that I believe you need when you purchase this is just this book, 384 pages. This is a religious curriculum, as all Master Books curriculum is. So it will talk about things about creation, and this is a science. So if you are a secular homeschooler, I don't recommend this curriculum for you. This year of study is going to talk about things like food chain, climates, forest structure, stewardship, decompensation. It's going to talk about science, as many lessons about God and our relationship with Him, God's design. There is no separate teacher guide. So the first few pages, and you'll see that when I do the flip through, is really all the instructions you need as the parent. There is an answer key in the back. So like the actual like assignments they do, you do get the answer key in the back of the book. Each lesson has like a material list, concepts, all of that before you start. It does recommend you have a science notebook. So just like a basic spiral notebook, whatever you choose, so your kids can take notes, they can draw. There are projects in this, and this is what I really liked about it. They are learning about the different biomes. So as they go through this, they're learning all the different biomes, and for each biome, they're gonna be making a diorama craft box of that biome. So just know that, like your kids are gonna be making a lot of like the same structure of things, but they're gonna need like the paper and all of that. So it says they will guide you how to make certain things. So when I was flipping through it, it's like, oh, this is how you could make grass for your biome. And it just kind of directs them like how to make and cut the paper, which I thought was really cool. But then it also says, you know, you can get model animals, trees, grass, plants. Hobby stores have tons of things on this. So that's something that if you have a kid that loves hands-on, loves animals, loves learning about like the different biomes, this would be a really fun unit for them. They do have some recommended books that you would get from Master Books, I think, and they're all animal specific. So seeing that, I feel like if you have an animal loving kid, this may be a really good option for you. There is a schedule that, if you've ever seen any Master Book curriculum, it's pretty similar to the schedules they have. So it's broken down by week and day, and a little checkbox is like what activity should be completed. There are 36 weeks of activities, five days per week is how it's broken down. But again, you could just use this as a checklist. You don't have to follow the 5 days a week. You could just run down and say, we did that, and kind of use it as that. So how this curriculum is set up. So think about the series name. It's called Let's Talk Science. So it's basically set up as a cute little conversation from the story characters. So I think there's two characters. I don't know if they're brother and sister, but basically they're like talking to your child in like speech bubbles. So I do feel like, especially at like a third grade level, that your kids could kind of read that on their own and work through the assignment, because it's kids talking to another kid in theory. So just an example of how it's written. Oh, good. We are so glad you're here. My name is Hannah, and this is my brother, Ben. So they are talking directly to your child, and they're in these like little speech bubbles. And this is how the entire curriculum is set up. So your child is learning along with Hannah and Ben through the entire thing. And that's what it reminds me of. It's like a little, you know, conversation between the characters and your child. It is all in color, and there are images They have certain words like highlighted with how to pronounce them and vocabulary, I believe. There are Bible verses written in. So here there's a Bible verse. There's some Bible verses in here. Sometimes it will tell you to go read a Bible verse. There are different activities throughout it. And so you'll see more when I do the flip through, but it says copy the sentence. So that's kind of like handwriting practice. This is what I thought was really cute. So we talked about those science notebooks. Sometimes kids or even parents are like, I don't know what to put in the science notebook. So here what I thought is really cute. It's like, hey, I think we should draw a simple food chain in our science notebook this week. And it says, good idea. We can use the food chain picture from the first lesson this week to give us an idea. So it tells your child like maybe where to prompt back to find it. But then they give examples of real like journal entries from kids. So I thought that that was really cute, especially for someone who's like reluctant or doesn't really like know what to write or they're just stuck. It gives them those examples and it's throughout the whole way like that. So I thought that that was super cute. I don't think there's tons of like hands-on activity where like you would buy like a separate lab kit, but there are things like this one. You would need a banana. You would peel the banana and leave the peel out, and then you do some observation on that and answer some questions. So that's a fun, easy activity. All right, and now we're on one of the projects. Now I've skipped through a ton, but this is the forest biome project. And so see down here how it gives you an example, a real life example. So that's if you need a curriculum that really is, I don't want to say in like a bad way, but hand holding, this may be it. Like I said, that third grade level, I feel like kids could read this completely on their own and understand it. But for those like extra prompts, that really, really helps. So that's helping them with their projects. It, like I said, it gives them ideas like how to make things. So, like, how do you make a tree? It has a toothpick, a little, I think, ball of clay, and how to cut it out. So it gives those all those ideas to really make it their own. And this is like pages upon pages of that example. And the back of the book, there's also a glossary. So all of those highlighted vocab words throughout the reading, if your child needs more of a definition, they can go to the glossary. That's just good textbook practice too, to teach them how to use those types of resources. So overall, I think this is a really solid program. I think it's a different approach because of like how heavy I think the reading is. There's a lot of handwriting practice, you know, vocabulary. And so this really is like more than just a science curriculum. I will say one of the reasons I looked at this is my second grader is using, I think, either level one or level two with her co-op class. And she comes home and she absolutely just has so much to tell me. She feels like she learned so much. And you know, I don't know how it's fully being presented in the co-op class, but she enjoyed it. And so I was like, okay, that's great. I don't know though, like just speaking for personally, because I really want, I don't think I'm at the level where I want their science to be separated. I don't think my fourth grader going into fifth grade would enjoy this aspect. And also too, she's very creative. And so she doesn't need those additional prompts. Those might actually deter her from doing certain things. So this, if you're just looking, you're like, you know what, we need a science curriculum. I need something that's not super teacher intensive, but engaging to kids. It has a little bit of hands-on stuff, but it really walks your kid through the hands-on stuff. This may be a really good option for you. It's pretty cost friendly because, again, you only have to buy this, and this is all you need besides, you know, some materials, but nothing seemed crazy on the materials. So we're not going to be using this in our homeschool this year, but I definitely think it's a great option for some of you out there. So I'm gonna do a quick flip through at the end of the video. So if you actually want to see like the whole book or most of it, I don't know if I'm going to flip through all 300 pages, stay tuned at the end because that's where the flip through will be. If you have questions about it or if you have your own personal experience using the curriculum, leave it down below in the comments. But thanks so much for watching, guys. I have more videos like this coming out of some of the other science curriculums we were thinking about or the science curriculum we're going to use. So I can't wait to share that. So if you're interested in the flip through, stick around.